Yeah.
Hey. It is 25 degrees. We are freezing, but thanks for joining us. We have some updates. Stick around. Hey, thanks for joining us. So, we're still really excited about the marathon that happened what seems like now a very long time ago.
It was like a month ago already.
Oh, really?
I think so.
But we're making plans.
Yes.
So, we're going to update you on our plans. Obviously, we were hit by a massive winter storm, and the temperatures dropped in the teens, ice everywhere. So we didn't get out. However, that's not why we didn't get out. We have some post-marathon pains that we're taking care of.
Yeah, and that we likely ignored for the last few weeks, months of training. You wanna go first or me?
Yeah, you go first and then I'll talk about me.
Okay. So I had this hip pain pretty much the whole time I was running.
Yeah.
And I, because I come from a long line of osteoporosis and osteoarthritis, I assumed I was starting to have the hip problems that everybody on one side of my family has. So I made a doctor's appointment, because we've tried to go for a run and I made it to the end of the block and had to stop.
Yeah.
It was so bad one day. I just couldn't.
Mm-hmm.
So that was when I realized like, okay, we've got a problem. I can't ignore it. Let's call a doctor. So the doctor, through a virtual visit, which was really interesting, figured out, like, we did a bunch of elimination type things to like get joint and bone stuff out of the way. So it doesn't look like that's what the problem is. What she determined was that I had pulled a groin muscle.
It's not funny.
Which is like, Do you have to call it that? Yeah. Can't there be a better name for this? So anyway, yeah, it's a muscle
There is a better name for it.
Your hip flexor, which is what my physical therapist is calling it. Yeah. But the doctor sent me in the portal, a little write-up of our visit and all the stuff she told me. And for whatever reason, you know, the whole thing's in a normal, sensible size font. But left groin pain is in like, 20-point font. It's like, what? Why? Why do you got it? Why? So anyway, I'm working on my hip flexor.
So,
I started physical therapy, doing a lot of like kind of isolating and strengthening weak muscles. Mm-hmm. The physical therapist was like, oh, you're a runner? I'm guessing you don't do a lot of strength training. I'm like,
And?
Yeah. So and, now I'm doing...
And stretching.
And stretching. So now I'm doing a lot of stretching and a lot of like strengthening in very specific muscles that have apparently never been worked because it is torture.
Yeah, you know, and I'm stretching with you,
mm-hmm.
and wow, I didn't realize, honestly, I didn't realize my butt muscles were so weak. So you know your glutes, right? Yeah. I'm doing these exercises and I'm like, holy mackerel, I'm getting tired.
Mm-hmm.
So stretching. Don't ignore stretching because apparently runners ignore stretching. So
that's me. I'm working on that. She thinks I'll be okay in a few weeks. So I already feel better. I've stopped. Oh, that was the other thing that made me call the doctor.
Okay.
I noticed I was limping when walking. So I'm no longer limping when I walk, but I haven't tried running yet.
Doctor's orders.
We'll try next weekend, I guess.
Yeah.
We'll talk about that in a minute.
Yeah, we're going to talk about that. My knee pain in both my knees was just way too much at the end of the marathon. And so I visit my doctor and I have some x-rays scheduled for this week. He's pretty sure it's not arthritis, so they just need to figure out what it is. X-rays, he said 99.9% of the time will show him everything he needs to see and then we'll proceed from there. So, you know, I'm really hoping it's physical therapy, but we'll see. You know, I just need to take care of these old knees. Because
we have plans.
Yeah, we do. We have lots of running plans.
First of all, we're going to sign up for the marathon, the Disney marathon again next year.
Right.
Which training for that, if we do the same 28 weeks, starts in like 20 weeks. So really, we're just kind of biding our time here in the next 20 weeks or so, trying to find some races here and there to keep us running. We're not going to do probably serious training, regimented training, but we have some races scheduled through early April, and then we need to look to find some.
Get this, starting July. A week from today.
Yeah.
So we are going to take back some races that went virtual because of the bad times. So we have Cupid's Chase.
Our annual Cupid's Chase here in town is just a little 5K, which is good that it's not a longer race because we haven't been running at all.
Right.
So we do that next weekend. Get another good long sleeve t-shirt. That's my favorite part of the race.
Yeah, right.
I have a supply of long sleeve t-shirts thanks to those races. Yeah.
And then we have a half marathon.
Half marathon that we plan to do in 2020. It went virtual and we did it. But, you know, it's really hard to run 13 miles around your neighborhood. Yeah. So it would be nice to run it in very scenic Fredericksburg, Texas, which is what we're going to do instead.
Yeah.
So we scheduled that one. So that's the end of March.
And then a big one.
A big one.
The big one with our niece. It will be her first ever 5K. She's training for it. Mm-hmm. We're going
to... She planned to run her first ever 5K in 2020. And then... You know,
canceled.
Understandably, she slipped off the running wagon because it was kind of weird times.
Yeah.
The race was totally postponed. Like, they didn't do virtual. They didn't cancel it.
Right.
They just said, hey, if you feel like hanging out and want to do this in the future, we'll hold on to your spot. So we didn't have to pay for this one. They finally rescheduled it for April, early April. And I interrupted you. Go ahead.
Oh, well, so, and we're going to travel all the way to... El Paso, Texas for that. It's a winery that's hosting this run, so we're excited about that. And then, you know, whatever else we can run as we, you know, get ready for regimented training for Marathon 2023.
Oh, God.
It's long. You know, it really is long. And we were looking at some of the race footage, other runners on YouTube, our own footage, and it's so exciting, right? I mean, there are portions of it where, and I even told you, I wasn't feeling great, but it's so great, you know, all of those weeks of training and everything you put into it, and then it's so hard, and you're running, and you're like, why do I do this? Why are we doing this? Are we going to do it? But you, it's exciting, and so we're going to do it again. So that's really neat. Hopefully this time, because we're planning runs and we're taking care of our bodies and stuff, when the training starts, you know, maybe it won't be such a jolt to our bodies.
Yeah. Because normally when we start training, well, the last two times we started training for the marathon, we were doing it cold, you know, we weren't running. And it's not easy to... So the training starts in June or July, and that's...
Yeah, it's really
It's not fun to go running here, during that period. So normally what happens is around like late April, early May, we don't run anymore because it's just too hot.
Yeah.
But we're going to try.
Yeah, we're going to try. And another thing that we're trying is looking at our form, our actual running form. You know, we know that we you know, can improve that and... one of the ways to do that is to work on something we never work on, and that's our core. So,
That's what we're doing.
Yeah, we started an Apple Fitness 30-day core challenge, and today is day 20.
Day
we haven't
20.
Skipped a day. Oh.
I feel myself sitting up straighter, standing up straighter, just naturally, which is good.
Yeah.
I've mentioned before that my posture is atrocious, and I would love to work on it, but it's just kind of a drag to work on your posture.
Oh,
so
yeah, it is.
Doing something that has the side effect of improving your posture is welcome.
So, you know, we're going to stick with that, and we're going to keep doing our exercise and stuff. We'll see, you know, what I'm going to have to do, and we're going to continue with what you need to do.
And we're going to try to do weekly updates still, because it will help us stay on track.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we'll definitely have updates. Obviously, a week from today, we're going to have race footage of our local...
That we may or may not be walking.
Cupid. Yeah.
Hip and knees pending.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe we'll skip it.
Like, not do it?
No. No, skip. I meant skip. I actually move faster when I skip.
Yeah, but can you do it for 3 miles?
No.
No way.
Oh, maybe we can skip walk.
Okay.
Skip walks.
We got plans.
We have plans. And because things are always an adventure, you know, one of the things we did on our marathon trip was something we've never done before. We're kind of hoping we never have to do it again.
This is a new one. Yeah.
We almost lost our lunch. No. when we arrived at the resort and grabbed our bag, our luggage that was carrying all of our food ripped open.
And other things, but it just happened to be food on that panel.
It ripped open.
The seam completely busted open.
Like,
it was open. We got lucky.
We were amazed.
It was a dinky piece of lining fabric holding everything in our bag.
And it was the food section, and we were amazed we didn't lose all the food that we'd taken. So we had to figure out how to repair it.
We're like, oh, you know who can help us? Bell Services. I bet they deal with this all the time.
Yeah.
They gave us packing tape.
Packing tape.
Which did not stick.
No.
We did our best, and it just peeled right off.
So, we place an online order for duct tape for pickup at a local Target.
Score another point for renting a car, because it was super easy to just pick up some duct tape on the way to the airport.
So, on the way to the airport, we left earlier. On the way to the airport, we navigate to this, brand new Target.
It was really nice.
Yeah, we picked up our duct tape, and because we didn't have time, we didn't have a lot of choices... We got the beautiful color of white.
We didn't have any choices. That was the only one. We tried to order black, and then they were like, oh, sorry. Apparently, somebody walked in the store, picked up the last roll of black duct tape, and the time it took us to place the order and for them to pick up the order. Anyway, so we got white.
Maybe it was somebody else with the same problem on the way to the airport. Anyway, so we did this
awesome... It looks real classy.
Yeah, we did this awesome duct tape fix in the parking lot of Target. Look at this.
It held.
Yeah, it...
And, you know, so we get back to home, and we're standing around the luggage carousel like...
Yeah, we're...
Did it work?
You don't want to be that person whose luggage
like,
comes down.
Like, all those my shoes! Like,
oh, that's not the underwear bag.
Oh, my dirty clothes! Oh. We did okay.
Yeah, we did. We did.
Duct tape is on the vacation packing list.
Oh, yeah. It is. Well, we have a big roll of white duct tape, so let us know what you're doing, what kind of training plans, what kind of runs you've entered in, or maybe you're going to do cycling or something. Let us know. We're going to update every week-ish, let you know how things are going. We really appreciate you watching. Let us know, because it's always an adventure with you.